Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man la. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassirli amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Afan Siddiqui. I'm from YM, New Jersey, specifically YM South Jersey, and I will be serving as the moderator today. I hope and pray that everyone is doing well, staying at home, safe and healthy, and has enjoyed and taken a lot out of the sessions thus far. On behalf of young Muslims and ICNA, I'd like to welcome you all to this online symposium and to the third session of today. Shaykh Saad Tasleem. Shaykh Saad Tasleem started Islamic education at IIASA in Fairfax, Virginia. He then went on to study at the Islamic University of Medina, where he dedicated himself to the study of Islamic sciences. He graduated with the bachelor's from the Faculty of Islamic Law at the University of Medina, and he will be talking to us about hope, Shaytan's greatest fear.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So our topic is the shaytan. And some of you may know this, I teach a seminar that takes an in-depth look at the shaytan. And it's very interesting, subhanAllah, because as I've taught this seminar, and even people who have attended the seminar, one of the things that often gets brought up is that as we go through events in life, you know, the ups and downs of life, it's very interesting to see how the shaytan uses his tricks, his methods of deception to take advantage of those moments. And especially moments in which we are a little bit, our emotions may be heightened. So whether it may be happy moments, joyous moments where our emotions get heightened, or moments that are difficult for us, and our emotions get heightened in that sense. So obviously, this time that we're going through is a time of pain and difficulty for a lot of people, and I know everyone is dealing with their own issues, everyone's dealing with their own difficulties, but without a doubt, the shaytan will try his best to take advantage of the time that we're going through. And so I really today wanted to speak about one of the shaytan's main methods of deception, and how, as a matter of fact, if we learn and understand that method of deception, we can actually be victorious against the shaytan. You see, the shaytan has been mentioned to us in great detail in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when you look at the statements of the shaytan, and in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually tells us of the speech of shaytan, how shaytan speaks and what he said, and what he said when he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on and so forth. And it's amazing how the shaytan makes these sweeping statements, these very arrogant and pompous statements, and it's as if he has so much faith in himself. It's as if he is so sure of himself, and he is so sure that he will be able to mislead human beings. So for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that the shaytan says, لَأَتَّخِذَنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِكَ نَصِيبًا مَفْرُوضًا. He tells Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, I will surely, meaning I will definitely take from your servants a specified portion, meaning a certain amount of your servants, speaking to Allah here, the shaytan says, I will definitely take for myself a specified portion. Also, Iblis said, قَالَ فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. He says, I swear by your honor, speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, swearing by Allah's honor should show us how arrogant and pompous the shaytan really is. He says, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. He said, I swear by your honor that I will mislead all of them. Once again, a sweeping statement. Also, the shaytan, Iblis, he said, قَالَ أَرَأَيْتَكَ هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَّمْتَ عَلَيَّ. He tells Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, do you see this one who you have honored above me? And in actuality, subhanAllah, the statement, if you understand the Arabic of it, and if you know and you speak Arabic, you get a very clear impression of how Iblis is being very dismissive of Adam alayhi salam, and how he is viewing himself above Adam alayhi salam. So he says, do you see this one? And he's putting him, dismissing him, not even calling him by his name, calling him this one. أَرَأَيْتَكَ هَذَا. Do you see this one? هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَّمْتَ عَلَيَّ. Do you see this one who you have honored above me? And then he makes his threat, how he threatens the children of Adam alayhi salam, he says, لَإِنْ أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. He tells Allah, if you delay me until the day of resurrection, meaning if you allow me to live until the day of resurrection, لَأَحْتَنِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. He says, I will, and this word, subhanAllah, لَأَحْتَنِكَنَّ, is actually a very powerful word. And, you know, in my seminar, we take a deep dive into this word. But this the meaning of this word really here is that he's saying, he is swearing. He's saying, I swear that if you allow me to live, then لَأَحْتَنِكَنَّ ذُرِّيَتَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. I will grab and seize and control the offspring, the children of Adam alayhi salam, except for a few. And now, subhanAllah, hopefully with these few ayat, you get an understanding of how threatening Iblis, the shaytan, is. And subhanAllah, one of the questions that I often get is why? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow the shaytan to live? You know, if he's so arrogant, he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he refused to obey Allah, and he became arrogant with it, and then he threatened Adam alayhi salam, he threatened the children of Adam, as we heard. Why would Allah allow him to live? Because the reality is, Iblis, after all of that, what did he say? قال, Allah tells us, رَبِّي فَأَنذِرْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. He says, my Lord, give me respite, meaning delay me, allow me to live until the day on which they are resurrected. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Allah said, قال فَإِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنذَرِينَ. You are amongst those who have been given respite. There you go. You want your life to be extended? You want to live until the day of resurrection? There you go. And so people often ask me, they say, why? Why would Allah, if he is so threatening, if he is so arrogant, why would Allah allow him to live? Let alone if we learn and understand the methods of deception, how the shaytan, the tricks he uses, it's really, subhanAllah, a question that can trouble us. So the methods of deception that the shaytan has, and in my seminar, subhanAllah, we go through over a dozen methods of deception. For example, how does the shaytan try to deceive us? One of his methods of deception is the distortion of reality. Well, how does the shaytan try to get us to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By distorting the reality of matters in one of two ways, or both ways. Either making evil look enticing and good, and Iblis actually even said this to us. He said, and he informed us of this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, قَالَ رَبِّي بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأُزَيَّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He said, my Lord, by the error that you have put me in, لَأُزَيَّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, I will beautify that which is upon earth for them. And what is he beautifying here? He beautifies our sins. He beautifies our disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَأُزَيَّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, I will beautify for them. Meaning, these matters that are sins, or they're evil, or they're bad, or they cause harm, all this negative stuff, the shaytan will beautify it for us. And that's how he distorts the reality of matters. And the other way is what the shaytan does, is he will take that which is good, that which is from the obedience of Allah, and he will distort it to make it seem bad, or make it seem difficult, or make it seem like something that we just cannot do. So this is one method of deception. Another method of deception, the shaytan uses our own desires against us. So the shaytan knows we as human beings, we have certain natural desires and certain desires from this world. And he will make sure that those desires are used so that we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the shaytan said, Iblis says, once again, Allah has informed us, وَلَا أُضِلَّنَّهُمْ وَلَا أُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. He said, I swear I will surely mislead them, and I will, وَلَا أُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ, and I will arouse in them their sinful desires. Their desires, those desires that will take them away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because he knows. He knows that our desires, if we fall prey to our desires, if we begin to worship our desires, if we listen to every one of our desires, then surely we will end up in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shaytan knows that in order to attain Jannah, in order to attain paradise, we have to be able to control our desires. As the Prophet ﷺ, he said, حُفَّةَ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِهِ, that Jannah has been surrounded with hardships, those things that we find to be difficult. وَحُفَّةِ النَّارِ, and the hellfire has been surrounded بِالشَّهَوَاتِ, with desires. Meaning it's very easy, subhanAllah, to go to the hellfire. All we have to do is give in to our desires. So the shaytan knows this. And so yes, he uses our desires against us. The shaytan, another method of deception, he will cause us to have doubts. And subhanAllah, in this day and age specifically, I know a lot of young people, and when it comes to their struggle with their faith, what I have observed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, that when someone is struggling with their iman, or they're struggling with Islam, their struggle falls in one of two categories. There's two main reasons why a lot of young people, or some young people, may be struggling with their faith. Either it is shahwat, right? Desires, meaning we desire something from this world, our worldly desires are keeping us away from Islam, right? Desires of this dunya. Or it is doubts, shubuhat. It's either shahwat or shubuhat. Doubts that we may be having in our deen, and that takes us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? And yes, the shaytan causes us, he encourages us to have doubts, as the Prophet ﷺ gave us one example. The Prophet ﷺ said, يَأْتِيَ الشَّيْطَانَ أَحَدُكُمْ, the shaytan will come to you, and he will say, who created this and who created that, until the shaytan says, وَمَنْ خَلَقَ رَبَّكَ, he says, and who created your Lord? What is this? This is a doubt. Right? And here the Prophet is saying that it is the shaytan who brings you to this line of questioning. And it's very interesting, subhanAllah, in 1500 years, nothing has changed. Till today, this is the same doubt that the shaytan often brings, that people often have, like, if God created everything, then who created God? You know, a common thing. The Prophet informed us about this 1400 years ago. All of these methods of deception, and this is just a small sampling, this is the tip of the iceberg of how the shaytan misleads us. So why, people ask me, why would Allah allow him to live? And the answer to that question is very clear. Allah allows him to live because Allah has given us the ability to protect ourselves against the shaytan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the greatest, most powerful weapon against the shaytan, that if we were to have and employ this weapon, then the shaytan cannot defeat us. What is this weapon? This weapon is hope. This weapon is hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a weapon that involves istighfar and tawbah. It involves seeking Allah's forgiveness and repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, the moment we seek forgiveness from Allah, the moment we repent to Allah, all of what the shaytan has done against us falls to the side. All of it becomes useless. The moment we say, Rabbi, my Lord, forgive me. My Lord, forgive my sins. With that forgiveness, the shaytan is defeated in everything that he has done so far. And it is because of this hope that we have the ability to defeat the shaytan. Because look, if we don't have hope, then we won't repent. If we don't have hope, we won't return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I have personally seen this happen with people, where people have come up to me and said, you know, I'm just a sinful person. I've committed so many sins. I've done so much bad, like this and that. Allah won't forgive me, right? So because of a loss of hope, they don't even try to seek Allah's forgiveness. And I know for a fact that that is what the shaytan encourages. That's one of his most powerful tactics to get us to lose hope. And that is why what he fears the most from us is us having hope in the forgiveness and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why Allah reminds us over and over again in the Quran. For example, Allah says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, say, O my servants, those who have transgressed against themselves, meaning those who have sinned and transgressed against themselves, لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِن رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Do not despair in the mercy of Allah. لَا تَقْنَتُ بِرَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الظُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. It is Allah who forgives all sins. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Certainly it is He who is all forgiving and all merciful. Here Allah is reminding us of how we can defeat the shaytan. As long as we have hope, the shaytan cannot win. And that is why as believers, despair should not even be despair should not be anywhere near our life. Despair should not be a part of who we are, because as believers, as long as we have iman, then we cannot despair in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why Yaqub alayhi salam, what did he tell his children, his sons? He said, do not despair in the relief of Allah. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرِينَ. It is only the kafirin, only the disbelieving people who despair. Because people of iman, people who have faith, then we do not despair, because our hope is tied into our hope is tied into our iman. That is why Ibrahim alayhi salam said, وَمَنْ يَقْنَتُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الظَّالُونَ. That it is only the dhalun, those who have gone astray, who lose hope, who despair in the mercy of their Lord. Once again, the dhalun, those who do not have the guidance. If we have proper guidance, if we have iman, then we always maintain our hope. And this is why this is one of the defining characteristics of believers. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all of the ways the shaytan, all of the threats that the shaytan made, all of the methods of deception of the shaytan, with all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us, inna kayda shaytani kana da'ifa, that the plot of the shaytan is so weak, it is ever weak, because we have this amazing ability, this amazing power to defeat the shaytan in having hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why, especially in a time like this, where we see sadness, we see difficulty, we see pain, we see suffering, yes, we can fall into despair. Yes, we can begin to think that there is no good outcome, that we will never recover, that we can never save ourselves from this situation. But as believers, we have to remind each other, and we have to be there for each other to inspire hope in one another. In these times, and in all times, do not be the helpers of the shaytan. Meaning, do not be those who inspire despair, whether it be on a macro level, life and faith in general, or even with individuals. How many people have we seen that help the shaytan bring despair to people? How many people look at someone and just write them off? This person has no hope. This person, you know what, they're just a sinful person. They're just a bad person. What is this? This is despair. This is the job of the shaytan. We do not want to help the shaytan. In these times and in all times, we want to be agents of hope. We want to be those who inspire hope in others. With all the difficulties, with everything we are dealing with, whether it may be matters of this dunya, whether it be matters of our health, whether it be matters of wellness, or it be the biggest matter, our faith. And we find this characteristic amongst all of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they would inspire hope in people. They would never let people lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my message for you today, this evening, inshallah ta'ala, that we don't know what we're going to go through. We don't know how long this difficulty is going to last. We don't know what difficulties we have ahead of us in these times and times to come. Life is full of difficulties. Life is full of hardships. But we have to be agents of hope. And we cannot be agents of despair. Because sometimes, subhanAllah, when we inspire others with hope, we end up inspiring ourselves with hope as well. And any person who is in a position of teaching and educating others, one of the things that they will tell you, and I can say this for myself, we're not perfect. Right? We're not free of sins. We're not free of faults. We all have our issues. We all have our own problems. We all have times where we feel overwhelmed. but we continue to invite others to good because we know, inshallah ta'ala, number one, inshallah ta'ala, there is reward in that, but also inspiring others inspires us as well. And when you see someone who is in despair and you encourage hope in them and you see them transform from a life of despair to a life of hope, that will do nothing but inspire you with hope as well. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us agents of hope in our life and in everything that we are going to face. Allahumma ameen. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Jazakallah khair, Shaykh Saad Tasleem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you and reward you immensely for all your efforts.